My first guest this evening enjoys long walks on the beach, reading a good book by the fire, and acting like a sociopath while he imprisons domesticated farm animals in underground domiciles. Everyone cautiously say hi to Ryan Haywood. My second guest moonlights on the weekends as a Waluigi impersonator, specializing in singing songs, doing balloon animals, and throwing painted tarot shells and banana peels at kids aggressively while laughing. It's a him, Ray Narvaez Jr.
That's me.
My third guest was raised by an advanced alien race of cat humanoids where she was taught to bathe herself with her tongue, chase flashing lights on the ground, and much to Michael's dismay, shit in a sandbox in the corner of the house. Everyone, it's a kitty, Lindsay Jones. And my fourth and final guest is a formidable woman of many talents, vlogger, journalist, cosplayer, and my favorite, the uncanny ability to put up with squeaky little British man-boy children who are obsessed with their own genitalia. Everyone say hi to the marvelous Meg Turney. I'm your host, John Reisinger. Welcome to On The Spot.
Much nicer to Meg than
Well, you know, I tried to play favorites, but
I'm glad
Meg
clarified again that you're cool with Twilight the genitalia as well.
I'm glad to see you've done no vocal exercises to give inflection to that at any point in the last week.
All
too.
One delivery.
Consistency is the key to being the talent.
You're still great.
Yeah. No one talked
Ray.
Over you, John. You're good.
We got a good cop, bad cop.
Yeah, really. I don't know how to feel about you guys.
We're both Liam Neeson.
Welcome to On The Spot, the official Rooster Teeth game show, where Ryan talks bad to me about me the entire time. Before we get into the actual game, we have a few points of business. We have to go over our team names first, so you guys can use hashtags to send berated comments to the teams.
Please.
We already have your team name, the family-friendly...
Cumstain Comrades.
Cumstain Comrades.
Do we like add something every time we win?
Mother Russia.
USSR right. Right.
Got it. Make it,
I love Tetris.
So we have your team name, hashtag CSC.
Yep.
We need your team name.
Team Free Willy over
That's
here.
Right.
That's
right.
And why are you guys called Team Free Willy?
We've been Team Free Willy, for like a year now.
Yeah, we bonded over Blackfish and Orca Rights everywhere.
Yes. Bonded over Blackfish, another good band name.
Yeah, that's true. But we decided that Meg is the child holding his arms up as I leap over her as Free Willy.
We need Photoshop right now.
Okay. John? When is the Team Free Willy shirt coming out?
Oh my gosh, please!
On to our second point of business.
Free Willy.
We need your help for our second game, our movie
now
pitch game.
So
if you could, please, using the hashtag on the spot, please send us a celebrity name, a place, and a film genre, and we will use the good ones in our film pitch game later. So again, celebrity name, place, and film genre.
If we don't use yours, it was one of the bad ones.
Right.
Feel bad about yourself.
That's a passive-aggressive way of just ignoring you. So, and I see, Ray, you brought the coveted Golden Gus.
Yes. I'm glad it was nestled between your balls
for
a while.
Where else we be?
Good. Keeping
right
it warm.
In the taint.
I mean, it is pretty phallic in its way, so it's kind of, it works for us.
It's also a great likeness of Gus.
It is. True. It's insane how close it is.
Great
likeness.
Like
we had it in Awu, and it was like in the forefront. It's like, there's the Golden Gus. So let's go into our first game of the evening, which is giving headlines. We have taken some questionable headlines from the news, and we've removed a word or two from the phrase, and we're going to ask you guys to fill it in and either try to get it right or at least do something funny.
No pressure.
Like I'm actor.
Yeah. I mean, you could answer something funny, or you could just do something funny and distract me from not realizing you didn't give the answer.
See, did I insult you again? That worked out well last time.
It did. You know, I don't think it'll work second time.
That's my tactic.
But feel free to try, and we'll see what happens.
Ryan, please. This is all that happened. I need this.
Let's go ahead and get our first headline. Our first headline is, Loose Blank on Plane Delays Flight. Loose Blank on Plane Delays Flight. And we're going to go to Team Free Willy first on this one. Lindsay. Loose blank.
My brain immediately said lips. Which ones?
Oh,
you can figure it out.
Yes. Loose lips. Delay flight.
You're the same person.
Wow, the information got out there.
What loose lips would delay a flight?
Well,
I don't know.
Loose lips, they sink ships.
It's true. This isn't a ship. This is a plane.
Anti rail planes.
The cockpit was rocking, so don't come a knocking.
Yeah,
kind of thing.
That's true.
Yeah.
The hat
lips.
Is on the door.
Think about it for a second.
That kind of loose lips.
There's lips aplenty.
Either someone's really sexually pleased or not sexually pleased enough, and that plane is not taking off either way.
So many lips.
Some woman just crosses her legs.
Yeah. That answer had so many levels. I appreciated that. I was so confused at the beginning.
Think about it.
Ryan, thank you for helping the other team explain their answer.
Asshole.
Ryan, now what's your answer?
Ninja midget.
loose the instrument on planes.
Look, those are really slowing down planes.
It's an epidemic.
The FCC needs to look in this immediately.
Fuck Ebola, man. The ninja midgets.
Good old NM.
I like how it's not just a ninja midget. It's a loose ninja midget. Yeah. So it was like it was being restrained.
Well, he was in
somehow.
A carrier.
Oh my.
Oh, good Lord. How else are you going to get him through security?
You've got to get him through security, exactly.
You've gone from using the wrong word to describe a group of people to referencing them to being a carrier.
Excuse me, sir. Do you
think
you're trying
to run the other levels of insults you want to add to this? I didn't say he was chicken sized. You guys took it there.
I didn't actually take it to that.
Sorry, John. We still like you.
Thank you, Ryan. That's all that matters. At the end of this game, as long as you like
little
me.
Little people.
Okay.
There you go.
Big world.
Ninja little people.
It's a good show. Meg!
Hi!
Hi! How you doing, Meg?
Good, how are you?
We're gonna have a discussion?
Yeah!
Okay, what's the answer?
Loose goose.
Loose goose.
That was a lay
Thank you, Ray. Brian helped with Lindsay's answer. Ray,
I do what I can.
Could you imagine if some like frantic steward, I guess airline attendants are trying to find the goose, like, please stop it, stop it.
How do you lose it? I think it'd be pretty easy to find.
Well, I mean, if you could lose a, what was yours, a ninja midget? Yeah. Like, I think a goose could be
lost. Have you ever held a goose?
Well, he's a ninja. Invisibility is his main skill.
Yeah, yeah.
Stop trying to make ninja midget happen.
Really
it will be a Cards Against Humanity.
There's a sentence that's never been said. Stop trying to make ninja midget happen.
She's like, not that happen. Yeah.
Next year, 2015.
Next year, it'll happen. Okay, goose. Yeah, a goose could cause some dismay.
Thank you.
In a plane.
Also, there's a little rhyme there. I feel good about it.
Loose goose.
Yeah. Loose the goose.
What was the name of that? The plane? The spruce goose?
Yeah, that was a plane. Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
Thank you.
It was great at flying.
Listen.
Yeah, really great. None of those were the answer.
Ray has gone.
I guess I won't even answer.
Oh, did you not answer?
No.
You helped with the goose thing?
That was my answer.
I thought that was your answer.
No, it wasn't.
Loose sound effects.
The loose exclamation.
Ray.
I'm going to go
You're doing
with,
a bang-up job, bud.
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 Thank you.
Going to go with a loose diddler.
A loose diddler.
On a paper bag. People are sitting down. He's like...
Get off me!
See that? That's gonna delay the flight.
Yeah. That was
the
very alarming.
Locked up already. If you're
no,
in the
he's
air.
He's aggressive about it. That door's not gonna stop
if he's
him.
Loose, does that mean he took
Once
the bag,
the bag
off
goes on,
too? No, he took it off. That's why he's loose. It's like you know who I am now.
Yeah.
That's not anonymous.
See, now she's helping me.
Everyone has to be diddled in the plane.
Exactly. Air marshal and all of this.
Everybody's getting
diddled.
He's the diddler.
It's like you can't stop me. I got the gun. What are you gonna do?
He's got a badge and a diddle.
He's gone mad with power. You bastard!
It's Liam Neeson again.
Shit!
Liam Neeson is the diddler.
Yeah.
Sure. Have we just
skipped to the movie round?
Oh my gosh! Yeah. All right,
you're welcome.
In this movie, though, he diddles himself. That's the twist.
The self diddle.
Yeah.
Next season,
thanks,
of
friend.
And everyone's, you know, it doesn't. It's, they just get a little uncomfortable. They're sitting
they're
next to him. He's got a blanket over it, but
but we all
you
know.
You know what he's doing.
Yeah. Jesus, there's something very aggressive happening over here.
So he looks like.
Okay, now that everyone's given their answer. Let's find out what the real it wasn't diddler.
Not lips.
But let's find out what the real answer was. The real answer was
crabs.
Crabs.
Mike.
No one expects it.
There's a mile high epidemic going on, all right?
You know,
special shampoo was being passed around.
Like, everyone
crabs
grab your merkins.
Or like, oh no, crabs.
I think it was crab people.
Oh, okay.
Like, crab people.
Crab people.
Got it.
No one got that one right.
You were so close.
You were so close.
Yeah.
I like the lips because that had so many levels to it. So I'm going to go points to Team Free Willy. Bang that job.
I'm all about complicated answers.
Yeah.
Please.
Well, it was like simple on the surface, and then you went down layers, and it's like, you know, an
just
onion.
Like the lips.
As I do.
Layers of lips.
It was actually my loose lips that caused that plane to be delayed.
You couldn't even keep a straight face with that.
No, I get it.
All right. So points to Team Free Willy. Let's move on to our next headline. Our next headline is man arrested after 300 blank found in home. Man arrested after 300 blank found in home. And Lindsay's already laughing at this one.
We're gonna
pause on that one, and we'll go to Team CSE for that. Ryan.
Is that me? Okay. Gerbils.
Crazy gerbil guy.
Crazy gerbil
That's
guy.
Why man arrested
Look,
for
I mean,
300
the,
gerbils? Why
cats have been done. Yeah. Like true. Dogs have been done. Gerbils. That's the next thing in crazy home pets.
Okay, so like that's just too
snakes.
Many.
Snakes. Yeah. No.
But,
well, I mean, they formed a colony.
But they're all in like the rolling balls.
Yeah. Except there's like, one.
There's he's one. Just like trying to get around.
There's one master gerbil that's actually living in the guy's head, directing him. Kind of like Ratatouille.
The master gerbil.
Yeah. Is he on a one story house or two story? Because you, could you imagine all those balls going down the stairs at one time?
You want to kill yourself because it's constant noise.
It's a duplex, but it has a basement.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Good.
Man.
So they're up north.
If 300 is too many gerbils, how many is not too many gerbils? Could you do like 20?
Well, it depends on how you're cooking.
299, actually.
Yep.
There's based never gerbils.
They eat those places. I think we covered this last time.
We didn't cover that they ate in a place. We just covered that you were crazy enough to say that you eat gerbils.
Wednesday night is gerbil night at Ryan's house.
Yeah.
That's what they eat.
So we got gerbil jerky, gerbil brains.
Gerbil giblets.
Yeah. You know, don't waste any part of the gerbil.
No. You're they make a fine weird, sauce.
You have a cape of like all these tiny gerbil bones.
Shut this one in.
It's
like a thousand gerbils.
They're so soft. It's all underwear. That's nothing but gerbil down
gerbil
here.
Gerbil pelt. Yeah.
I took this one down in 03.
Again, there's fan art I want to see of all this that is being described of gerbil pelts.
You brought this on yourself.
And gerbil skulls around.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm ready.
Okay, gerbils, fantastic answer. Lindsay.
My brain went to orphans.
So. Wow. Orphans.
Manorist, there's 300 orphans.
Maybe he just really... called an orphanage, though. Guys. Oh, what's that? Your parents don't love you? Live here, kids.
I assume he's
and
not licensed.
Arrested
yeah,
for
he's not licensed.
That's not fair.
You can't just be like,
that's
yo, kids.
That's sexist. If it was a woman, it'd be all right.
I made my own man.
Automatic pedophile.
Are you telling
300
me?
Kids.
I cannot go up to children right now and be like, listen, I opened up an orphanage in my apartment.
Dude,
if you guys
want to
hang out with me, that's cool. I
mean, don't do that, though.
In the realm of could you
do that?
You could.
I could.
Should you, you should.
Yeah.
But, you know, let's just be in the realm of could. Yeah, I mean, why not?
Yeah.
You know?
Orphan stays.
Orphans.
Okay.
Okay, orphans. Good answer. Ray.
I'm going to go with slaves.
Oh, well, what up?
300 slaves.
Yeah. No. It got shit done. Dude's
that's
lazy.
What the orphans
he's
are.
Like, man, I would really like a second floor in my house.
They complain less.
Go.
That might be overdoing it with how many slaves are required to make a second floor of a house.
Yeah, they're pretty fast
like would,
about it.
You would think they'd be like all over themselves. Yeah. Like, there are too many of us here. We should like.
Well,
cut
they actually
down.
They form the walls like Ultron. Yeah. Wow. They just stack them up.
And
but
we
the
went
on top of each other.
What a
how
surprise.
We started dark.
Yeah, but you made them make the walls. Like you went like Great Wall of China.
Yeah, I didn't say like make a pyramid. I just said second floor.
Yeah, how long did it take him to make the pyramid of Giza?
Like 6-7 days.
Yeah, they got this.
300
there was a
slaves turn into walls.
On,
you'll have a balcony in no time.
Okay, slaves. Yeah. Sure. I mean, that would be reason to be arrested.
Child slaves. Merge the answers.
Megara.
I think one will do it.
Dead Spartans.
Ooh.
Dead Spartans.
I was hoping someone would go that
Thank
route
you.
Because I
remember that when you're thinking about points.
But they're dead.
Oh, well, yeah. Well, I mean, they've been dead a long time.
Spoilers.
They made their way into the house,
oh, yeah.
And there's just 300 dead Spartans.
He's just...
And one man was arrested for it.
He was hustling Xerxes.
He was saying...
There was one of the Spartans.
Yeah, you're right.
Well, this is a sequel.
Yeah.
He's back. And he's taking out his vengeance on the Spartans.
I think it's a sequel to the movie, and some dude just comes home and he's like, oh shit. No, it wasn't me. It wasn't me. I didn't do it.
It was actually Shaggy.
Yeah.
And he sings
Xerxes.
About it. Then they caught me in the shower.
And then that guy raps, and I can't understand
and
what he's
was
saying.
300 Spartans on the floor.
Shaggy.
I'm not going to do more of their work for him.
Yeah.
Oh, not again.
There's a lot of team help going on here. You guys are doing a good job of helping each other.
Yeah.
A lot of,
teamwork makes the dream work, everyone.
We have to work on the aggression going on here.
Rawr.
Bring it.
Thank you, Ryan.
I can kick from here.
No, please.
So none of those, I believe, were the correct answer.
You don't know that.
Damn it.
Really?
There wasn't 300 gerbils in a house. Funny
it's
going to
be gerbil related, though, right?
Man arrested after 300.
It's a very active asshole.
Oh,
see, it was snakes.
Snakes was my backup.
Snakes.
Oh. He's not on board with the gerbils yet.
I love this picture.
Look at this woman holding her nose.
Look at this journalist, like, trying to get the story.
They're all horrified.
But cannot smell
did
it.
Did someone, like, just rip ass near her? She's like, oh, God.
It's that guy who's looking surprised. Oh, well, that was me.
Like, here's the thing. The guy with the 300 snakes in his house really needs to get together with the guy with the 300 gerbils, and that'll just solve both problems.
Or the woman with the 600 cats in her van.
I don't know if the 300 snakes would be solved.
Yeah.
That would feed the 300
they'll
snakes.
They'll choke. There'll be a lot of choking.
Why? Why would they choke?
Do
you're
snakes
just gonna make the snakes
choking.
More powerful with
like,
all the
snakes
choking.
Able to, like, devour, like, deer and stuff like that. Like, a little gerbil's not gonna, like, cause a problem.
They're fuzzy, and they
you
tickle your
how
throat.
You know how big snakes are?
He says from experience.
Yeah, that's why you skin them first.
Ryan, you're so fucking weird.
Thanks, Ryan. So,
never go hunting with Ryan.
Nothing bigger than a gerbil, though. Yeah. that's as far up the food chain as I make it.
Arrow. Just threw a gerbil.
Gerbils, yeah.
Ryan's going to find a baby and be like, you're about the same size.
what kind of baby are we talking to? It's like a fetus.
A preemie?
Yeah.
Preemie.
Just
there's a preemie in the woods. Probably not already.
Not to stop the preemie talk, but I got to pick a winner for that one. I actually liked gerbils. Like
gerbils!
The Spartans were a good answer, but the image of 300 gerbils is quite adorable in my head.
Oh, they're terrifying.
All moving around?
No, yeah. Don't ever go in that room when they're out of the balls. They'll just devour you.
Just roll over someone. Yeah.
It's like that scene from The Mummy when all the scarabs run over the guy.
Yeah.
Do they go into the skin and everything?
There's just a skeleton left.
Gerbils popping out of his skin.
There's just a herd, and they go over him, and then what's left behind is
it's
just
like a cartoon.
Desiccated.
A man reaching like this.
So points to Team CSC. Let's go on to our third and final headline. Our third headline is Britain's first blank-powered bus takes on the road.
Oh.
Britain's first blank-powered bus takes on the road. And we went with Team CSC last time, so we'll go to Team Free Willies. Free Willies.
Several Willies.
That's a different one. That's a different movie.
That's a
Triple X version.
Meg. Britain's first blank-powered bus takes road.
It's its first wank-powered bus.
Wank-powered. What would power the actual wanking motion or the result afterwards?
You're creating an exothermic reaction.
It's both, right?
Like the friction.
Like the friction, and then when you charge up the battery, you get like the full release.
Discharge. Yeah.
Well, we don't call it that. That's the bad. Let's maybe not call it that part.
I would get the wheels turning, and then we just stop abruptly. Like, all right, we're here. It's your destination.
Yeah, it's really fast.
Should
have
taken a train, assholes.
It has to stop for 15 minutes.
Guys, can we just coast? I gotta cool down a little bit.
Someone tag out. Or tag me out.
We need to do some cleanup afterwards.
Don't touch anybody's hands on the wank bus, please.
We put on cruise control.
Chill. No, that would work. Britain's first wank-powered bus takes road.
I think it would work.
They can hit up Purell.
If this wasn't actually the story, it should be eventually.
Thank you.
Ray.
I'd like to think of a British Flintstone, so I'm gonna go feet-powered. Just everybody just
a punch. And then the people on like the double decker part are just the moochers.
Those
are the rich people's
royalty.
So it's a hierarchy going on.
They're flapping their arms to keep the wind going.
Yeah. Remember the geese?
They're turning around and just blowing in the opposite direction. Just
some people
got the dinosaur
farting,
in the back.
That's
crazy over there.
That's a very environmentally conscious as well as the wake car.
Or both.
Yeah. That's what the
renewable energy.
They're waking on the top and they're running.
You are the future, Meg.
Thank you.
They wink downward and got an umbrella. And
wink downward.
It's a whole thing.
Another good one.
Wink downward. That's a first hit single.
That's the first hit single for the album. Lindsay, 300, I mean not 300, went back to the last one. Britain's first blank-powered bus takes road.
I thought about the lovely queen and her sweet corgi, so I thought about corgi-powered. A corgi.
But how do you kill a corgi?
No, please. I'm not an animal.
I thought you were going to say Britain's first queen-powered bus takes road.
Shove it in the tank.
I was like, that's genius.
No, I was thinking like a bus, but you have a bunch of corgis in front of it like a sled team. You're like, yeah. Go, my lovely.
That's like Narnia shit.
So many slaves on this episode.
Imagine a bus going like,
I want everything.
Super slow.
I want everything I own to be powered by corgis and children. That's what I want.
Corgis in the front, children pushing in the back.
Oh yeah.
Chop chop.
Oh, Ray shaking his head
it's
to me. I went too far.
Britain,
I went too far on that one.
What about like solar powered? You got kids involved.
Solar power on the top.
Still the feet though.
And then winking inside. Okay, cool. Corgis. Always love corgis.
They're cute.
Ryan.
Flatulence.
Nice.
Flatulence.
Yeah. They give you a can of beans when you get on the bus.
Oh,
you just shotgun it, and then you just sit on a specially designed receptacle. Just methane all the way.
I believe they call that a toilet.
Well, like something a little more like actual like airtight would be more efficient.
Yeah.
No, I don't need anything making my ass airtight.
It's like the space toilets. They've got this technology. The space toilets. They just suck it right out of you.
Yeah, they do.
Jesus. Well, wait a second. They don't suck it out of you.
Look, optional queef power for the ladies, okay?
Thank you. Equality.
There you go.
That's a vagina fart.
Thank you, Ray.
For all the kids out there.
Ray's very familiar.
It's about the loose lips.
I have no idea what a vagina looks like, John. I'm just brainstorming here.
That sounded very close to the South Park episode, the sound effects they made on the
What if the
episode.
Pilot of the airplane thought it was a bomb going off, but it was just a really intense queef? That's why the plane was delayed.
A really intense
Super
queef.
Super intense queef delays.
Where were you 10 minutes ago? Where was I?
Ryan, I thought you were going to go for gerbil balls.
Use gerbils. The gerbils are done for now.
I think you should change that to your team names. Hashtag super intense queef.
No, it's too late now.
No, the name was too long. We got flagged like that. No. Super rainbow dance party, whatever the hell we were.
Yeah, super rainbow dance party. We're adding names.
Slumber party dance. There we go.
Rainbow party?
Let's find out the answer. The answer was Britain's first poo power.
Wow, that was so close.
You should have thought more solidly. Yeah.
Now, is that shit on the windows or is that rain?
Yeah, it's like, steamy in there.
The color balance on that was not really thought through. But yeah, it's a poo powered bus that actually uses like the gases and such from the poo.
That woman looks so disgruntled. Just, she went away.
I imagine this bus going down the street and there's just this wave of people on the sidewalk going,
like the whole bus is like even like wrapped in like advertising of like letting people know exactly what is powering this
bus. You want to bet that Gavin was on the side of that bus?
He was on the other side.
That's the slow-mo bus. Well, it's the shit bus, but I mean, it's a bus.
Hey.
I'm not on a bus.
I think it's pretty obvious who I gotta give points to. I mean, you got pretty damn close
to it.
That
was good.
Just that far off.
Damn it.
So points go to Team CSC. All right. I mean, that's. I mean, it was literally the gases powering the bus. So
fair enough.
I thought I was way off there too.
Yeah,
like they like literally have like receptacles for the you know. The
accidentally close to
the
wait, what? No, they don't.
No, they don't. Jesus.
Don't slam anything.
That's how it goes back in the way it came out. It's go out of the person
what
into the bus.
What are you talking about?
Slamming shit into a toilet.
I want that to be
ass you have that you're slamming shit into a toilet.
Cartridge of shit.
Look, I go through a lot of toilets, okay? It's like once
it's
a month.
Like a brick, okay?
Once a month, I gotta go to Lowe's, all right?
I need a lot of fiber.
Can you imagine if you did that with weaponry?
I have credit now.
You load the magazine with shit. You're like, I'm ready to lock and load.
Is Monty gonna incorporate it? Monty, please, cartridge of shit.
The half gun, half potty.
I believe somebody walks around the office and sees like a little cartridge of shit on the floor, like ammo in a game. And they're like, oh, Ryan was here.
This will get me home.
Yeah.
All right. On that note, let's find out what the points are. The points
Point
after giving headlines are Team CSC with 50.
We made the math too easy.
Sorry, do you want to hard? Team CSC with 49 and Team Free Willies with 25.25.
Yeah, take some points away so there's this more awkward.
John,
you're getting close, okay?
Okay.
Shut your whore mouth.
I was worried about
this.
Talking over him at
first
the beginning.
First warning.
Like I'm going to open my whore mouth.
Let's go on to our second game. Our second game is Impromptu Pitch, where our teams will be pitching to me their next film idea using prompts that we get from Twitter, and I will be the one to decide who wins by giving the best pitch. And the twist is that you guys can only give the pitch one person at a time, and I will be the one deciding who gets to change around and giving the pitch. We asked Twitter for some prompts. So what is our first set of prompts we got from Twitter? Liam Neeson, kindergarten, and a horror.
Oh, God.
And we're going to go with Team Free Willy on this one. So Liam Neeson's kindergarten.
Damn it.
And horror.
Did you have a good
and
one?
Your, it's like your physical prop you also have to use is...
My God.
The hourglass.
Okay. All right.
The original hourglass. The OG.
It can't be the original. I thought the original one broke. Or
no,
this
was before the one that broke.
Oh.
This one's plastic.
Okay. This was like something from
Work
like,
that in if you can.
From like Labyrinth.
David Bowie's balls. Look at my crutch. Look at it, everyone.
This is an hour,
falling.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, so we can't use this to time your pitch.
No, not at all.
1 hour long pitch starting now.
Just for the joke, John.
Okay, so 60 seconds on the clock. Your Liam Neeson kindergarten horror film involving the hourglass. We'll start off with you, Lindsay. Ready, set, go.
The setting is New York City. The time is 1980. Liam Neeson goes to a playground in which his niece is playing and he's watching her lovingly.
Meg.
But then it turns out that his niece actually died 10 years before in a kindergarten accident on the playground.
Lindsay. Yes, he likes to go there to reminisce and watch perhaps her ghost appear, but so far she is not.
Meg.
Then he sees on a swing set an hourglass and it's turned over, and as the grains of sand
Lindsay.
Are falling through,
he realizes he is the Prince of Persia and must use use the hourglass to save his niece.
Meg.
And whenever he falls off of a platform or goes astray, he turns the thing over and it goes back to a safe point where
and he reach, where he can reach out to his niece's hand just before she dies. And she goes, Liam, no! That's actually
Meg.
And he, he figures out eventually that if he rearranges all the playground furniture or things in the setting, then she'll come back to life.
Lindsay.
So finally, after placing the slide under the jungle gym perfectly, he's able to reincarnate her ghost, and she's actually a zombie person.
Meg.
And she tells him that her teacher killed her.
That's a twist.
Boom.
That was amazing. That was amazing.
Wow. I thought I was ready for the twist, but I wasn't.
I wasn't. I'm not ready to go next.
No one expects Prince of Persia.
I saw sand in there.
No one expects Middle Eastern Jake Gyllenhaal.
That is very correct.
True.
Ladies, the name of this fantastic film is...
Through the Sands of Time.
Oh, man. You beat me.
Okay.
You should have gone to Rude Sandstorm.
I was going grain by grain.
Grain by grain? That was fantastic. Great, great job.
So we got
so space.
Let's find out what
if you go to space again.
Child's play.
That was great. Okay, Team CSC, your prompts.
Liam Neeson. Betty White.
Betty White. Hunger Games. Arena.
Fuck.
A rom-com.
Fuck.
Betty White and Hunger Games Arena.
What? Yes. Betty White's still alive?
Yes. She is. All right. She is really old, but she's alive.
Kicking. What's a rom-com?
Romantic comedy, Ryan. Come on.
Ryan.
I get it now.
And your prop is...
Oh.
Jesus Christ. Didn't
That's
this kill
cool.
someone in Indiana Jones?
Yes.
Maybe.
I like the dragons.
Drink out of it, Ryan.
The dragon goblet.
No longer
okay,
topical.
So Betty White, Hunger Games Arena.
Okay.
With a rom-com with the goblet. 60 seconds on the clock. We'll start with Ray.
God.
Ray, your best pitch ever. Go.
All right, so Betty White is the queen of this arena. We won't call it Hunger Games, so you don't want to get sued. So she gets all these young, hot men to fight for her because
Ryan.
She's...
But, yeah, so the men fighting for her, though, are also going for this lovely chalice, which is adorned with dragons, because this holds the power to bring Betty White back to a young age.
Right.
So she can...
Turns out that's actually her. She is a dragon. She's like masking as Betty White because that's the only thing she could do.
Ryan.
And so she disguises herself as a man named Frederick Winkelbaum. And Frederick Winkelbaum falls in love
right.
with another...
With one of the men. And it's a comedy because they're gay, right? And nobody sees that coming. But they're in love.
Ryan.
There's nothing
but
wrong
then
with
she
that.
Drinks from the chalice and turns back into Betty White. And he's like, oh, I'm not into old women.
Yeah.
Ray.
Because he's gay. Because he's into old men. And it turns out Betty White turns into Frederick Winkle Snatcher, whatever his name is, who's actually an old guy. And they're going to like do old people bang sex stuff. And things that really like dusty because they haven't used in a while, like the vag. There's no vag; it's a butthole because there's no women. It goes.
Frederick Winklebot. What is that?
Listen, go to space.
That's true.
Oh my god. That was the worst thing ever.
I'm so sorry.
I think it held together on some levels.
It was great.
I didn't even know what was happening in that.
Me either. I don't even know how it ended. Oh, they banged, right?
Well, no, they weren't into each other. They went their separate ways.
Yeah, that's right. Okay.
Yeah.
I think.
All right. So whatever the hell you just explained, what was the name of it?
Wrinkle and Betty.
How about The Fappening Part 2?
Oh, Wrinkle and Betty, The Fappening Part 2.
There you go.
It's a hybrid title.
Yeah.
There's a colon in there.
Wow.
It might be in Betty, I don't know. Right.
Wow. This is tough.
Frederick, I hate you.
Frederick Winkelbaum is a solid character.
I love his work.
Who plays him?
Who doesn't play him? It's a character for the ages.
No, but
it's like
that?
A Shakespeare work, man.
Okay.
Like
oh,
you
like
inherit the character
yeah,
of Freddy. Yeah. Yeah,
Henry Winkler.
Okay.
There you go.
Damn
okay, so,
hey.
Benedict solely on the fact that I was able to follow this film, I'm going to go with Team Free Willy.
I would too.
Yes,
I would too.
Thanks,
so,
Ray.
50 points to Team Free Willy for
yeah,
that one.
Yeah, right.
What does that signify?
Yet. Nothing. And I have won.
Time is a construct.
At the end of our second game, we'll go to our points. Our points now are Free Willy's with Free Willy. I keep saying Free Willy's.
Free Willy's
75
several.
And Team CSC
Free
with 50.
Free the Willy's.
Yeah.
So We'll give you guys the opportunity to catch some points up.
How many push-ups can you do?
With Ray on your back. Yeah. No, we have actually a really nice so a nice little game for you to do. It involves eating some this. Very
wrap it up.
Healthy.
How come the first
sardines.
Time they didn't have to eat shit?
Listen, dude, I don't know.
Sardines are actually really good for you.
Can we have a physical challenge?
No.
Yes, I'll eat the sardines.
This is a physical challenge.
Physically down these us. Sardines. So you can have a fork if you want.
You can wrestle me or not wrestle me. Sardine?
No, I'm about challenge. To.
I'm going to vomit on you. I'm not going to lie.
What, why? There's so much more space, like
there
right there.
Not
no.
Project.
There you go, right there.
Thanks.
And these shoes are old. Go for it.
Sorry.
We're going to go ahead. And open these things up. Do sardines smell?
Yeah.
We're about to find out.
Yes, they do.
Does anybody have a garbage can nearby?
Aren't those anchovies or are they sardines?
They're sardines. This is really full.
Oh, wow. You're going to make a mess on the set and Gus is going to kill you.
I'm trying my best.
Dude, you know, there the juice!
That's the best part.
Oh, Jesus.
Now you have to eat one.
All right.
So the cat lady attacks.
So, it looks like there's about... You know, four big old chunks in here.
I drank my Red Bull already.
No, thank you.
Maggie's he's freeing the willies, man.
All right, so 10 points of a chunk. So you guys can divvy that out.
Oh, it smells.
Hey,
rough. I got some on my hands.
It's before like I die, I can just eat these whole, right? Like there's no like, technique.
Yeah, yeah. In fact, I eat sardines on occasion.
How do you
actually
get
really good for
this
you.
Out?
You
use your spoon. Ready?
Just like that.
Wait, no, there's not a chunk there. It falls apart.
Okay.
Just give me this thing.
Later.
Where's your spoon?
Just like
spoon.
Cat food.
Just like mash it up.
There you go.
Like Play-Doh.
Ray is visibly right. shaking as he does
this. Oh
my
god, no.
So this is for 40 points?
This is for 40 out. Points.
40.
They have to eat the whole can.
Just get him out!
Not the whole can.
The whole can!
Alright. Ready, set, go! Oh,
what do we got in time? What do we got in time?
30 seconds.
Can somebody get me a drink?
Oh god. It's falling apart.
Turn towards the camera, please.
No!
God, I can't get any.
That's what it tastes too bad.
Yeah, they don't taste that
no,
bad.
No, it's okay.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. It's okay. It's okay.
God.
Oh. I can't get any more. You didn't open the can far enough.
You got 15 minutes left. 15 minutes to eat it.
Are you proud of me, Mom?
Spit it out of my hand.
Brian, off really quick.
No, it smells so bad.
How many did you get down?
Okay, we'll give you got about 30 points worth. 30 points.
Nice. Ryan commits.
That was fantastic.
Not as much as Ray, dude. Ray was all over it.
I took like four fucking
minutes. Oh, my God.
I went after it, but not. I couldn't get to it. Ray was too intense.
That was a moral
Meg,
victory.
Do you want the rest?
No, thank you.
You know my hand?
I'm gonna be honest.
I can smell it from here, thanks.
I'm gonna be honest. It's a lot milder tasting than you thought
it
was.
Yeah.
It smells terrible.
They get a bad rap from like cartoons.
Yeah.
That was great. So 30 points to Team CSC.
Hey, we're winning now.
And you also got some good nutrients in your
system. Yeah, we got a free dinner.
Leave it out for me to knack on later.
Let's go on to our third and final game, which is Quick Thinking. It's a twisted version of Hot Potato, where we will give the teams a category and a letter, a starting letter, and the teams will come up with answers for the category, beginning with the letter. The letter will change throughout the category. And we will put 60 seconds on the clock per category, and we'll go back and forth. I'm also the one to decide whether or not it's a good answer or not. And you also have the opportunity to pass if you don't have a good answer. 10 points to each good answer. Let's find out what our first category is.
It is a little bit like someone murdered an oyster in my mouth.
I need to throw up in my hands.
Our first category is surprising things to yell when climaxing.
Oh, I've got this covered.
From the repertoire of Lindsay Jones. Our first letter is...
Yahtzee.
Gee.
Don't get me.
Okay, we're gonna start with since we started you guys on the pitch, we'll go with Team CSC on this
one. You wanna start or should I start?
Ryan?
Glad you're my sister.
Well, let's get
you're from Georgia, you sick fuck.
I'm really glad we didn't start the game yet because we all get to just stop and be appalled by you for a second. 60 seconds on the clock.
What?
Alright, say it again, I guess.
Do you
no,
have
I gotta come
up
with a new one.
Ready?
No, okay. Not really. Yeah. I'm a stepsister.
Fictional.
Go.
Gamergate's real.
Sure.
Go the distance.
Perfect.
Gavin!
Never once said that. That's weird. Geodude.
Good. Jesus. R.
Rapunzel.
Weird, okay.
Roller coasters rock!
Ryan!
Yes!
Regigigas!
What?
That's it's a Pokemon.
Okay, good.
C. Crepes!
No.
Cunts!
Perfect.
Children!
What?
Cats!
Yes!
Yeah. I don't like kids.
No, I took it the right way. You're impregnating a girl. Kindergarten!
God, what's wrong with you?
Klingons!
Yes!
Ku Klux Klan!
Yes!
Kitty cats!
Yes! No, cats, can we say cats? Bad.
Come on.
Euthanasia!
Oh, God!
Emigration with an E.
Sure.
Eucalyptus!
Perfect.
Aww.
If we had gone, do you make the jib one?
Eminem.
Yeah.
The rapper? Yeah. He's a hot white dude.
Slim Shady, please.
Stop standing up.
Get back down there.
Down.
Spaghetti.
Okay, that was a great first round of quick thinking. We're going to go and move on from that interesting round, Ryan.
What are you looking at me for?
Why do you think I'm looking at you?
You fuck your sister, apparently. That's what I got out of that. I still love you the same, though.
Second category is childhood nicknames for the host with a visual aid. I'm going to remind you, I wasn't a child. That was 18-year-old John.
Last time I got 5 points for being mean to you, now it's a category.
Yeah, now it is. All now right. You can actually let loose.
What's happening on your bottom half? Why is that off
That's
camera?
That's the mystery. That's okay. The mystery. The crop of the photo leaves the mystery.
Yeah, leave some to the imagination, right? Please.
All right, we're going
to
start with Team Free Willy on this one. 60 seconds on the clock. Starting with the letter T.
Oh, man, thick. I was already there.
Would you wait for me to say the round's going? What is wrong with you? This whole show is deteriorating.
You knew what you asked for when you brought these people on the stage.
60 seconds on the clock. Ready, go.
Traumatizing.
Yes.
I'm sorry, Tubbs. Thunderbond.
Thank you.
You look great.
Sure.
You remember the magazine? No, nobody?
What?
Tiger Beat?
Thunderbuds.
Thank you. Yes.
Tugboat.
G.
Toot toot.
G. Oh.
G.
God.
I never got that one. You.
Great host.
Thank you.
Godzilla thighs.
Perfect.
Groper.
Sure. R.
Roly Poly.
Yep.
Risinger.
Nope.
Oh.
Ragemonger.
Yeah.
Riptide.
No. L.
Lots to love.
Yes.
Lesbian.
Yes.
You look like a lesbian.
Answer fuck. Lollipop Man.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
Loving stuff.
Yep. H.
Holy shit, you're fat.
Yes.
Handsome.
Oh.
What does that mean? Do I get points?
It's like half a point.
Hot stuff.
There you go.
I hope that stage is well supported.
Good. Oh, such a good time at my expense. All right, so that's the end of a wonderful round of quick thinking. I'm just going to go repress all of that and
just blog about it.
You and I can talk about being fellow fat kids together.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Oh,
there's a support group.
So much
same.
Fun. Yeah. Were you fatty?
No. This is the most I've weighed. I weigh like 140.
Yeah. So that's the end of our games. And while we added the score, we want to take a moment to do a little plugging. What do we have going on after the show, Lindsay?
All right. Well, after this, we have a stream for X-Ray and Bev because we are premiering the show next Thursday, which is crazy. So we're a week out. We're going to do just a cast and crew stream. If you want to come by, say hello, ask some questions
about
the show.
It is open to everybody. You don't need to be a sponsor.
Yeah, not sponsor only, to clarify. Go to the front page of roosterteeth.com and you'll see it there in a couple minutes. Ray's going to be there.
I'll be there.
That. Yeah, talking about
I'm
some stuff.
X-Ray.
Yeah. Surprise.
Thank you for clarification.
Yeah,
those
yeah.
who don't know. Yeah.
Shit, spoilers.
Do we have points now?
We do.
We have points. Our final score.
My hands smell awful.
My everything smells awful.
Let me just rub it on Gus so we find
you bastard.
Our final
score.
I'll
be part of him forever.
Is. Ta-da.
Damn it!
Thank you.
Let's,
thank you.
And Lindsay made it weird.
Jesse smelled great.
Thank you for joining us for this very unique episode of On the Spot. Be sure to join in next week for Thursday at the same time for another episode where Team Free Willy will take on a
metaphorically
new team.
Hold it with me.
Oh, yeah. Good.
That's it for On the Spot. Thank you, everyone. Good night.